What's going on, everyone? Brian here from Native Instruments. I'm excited to share a huge advancement that we just made when using the Kontrol S-Series with your DAW. Since release, we've made improvements that make using the Kontrol S-Series one of the most powerful keyboards out there. This includes custom MIDI templates, onboard play assist features like scales, chords, and art mode. You can now control any non-NKS instrument and effect directly from your keyboard inside of Ableton, Logic, Cubase, Bitwig, and Digital Performer. Let's jump into it. For the integration to work, you'll first need to update to the latest version of the hardware connection service and update the firmware on your keyboard. For this video, we're going to be using Ableton, so additionally make sure that you're up to date with the most recent version of Ableton. The first thing I'll do is drag analog onto my first track, and you'll see on the keyboard I'm now able to control all of the parameters inside of analog. This means that you can record this as automation directly into Ableton. If you want finer adjustment, you can hold down Shift and turn the corresponding knob. This allows for finer increment adjustments. Using the left and right arrows, I can toggle through the different pages of parameter controls within inside of analog or any instrument. If I select a different preset from analog, you'll see also on the display that the name of the preset is also displayed on the keyboard. Let's load up another analog instrument, but one that's in an instrument rack. When the instrument rack is loaded, you'll notice on the display a little plus sign. This will expand everything in the instrument rack, allowing you to see the instrument and all of the effects that are included. Pressing the buttons at the top will allow you to toggle and switch between all of the components inside of the instrument rack. Also, if you want to rename the instrument rack, you can just do so here, and whatever you name it is going to show up properly on the display. In addition to naming the preset, the color of the track also is mirrored or reflected on the keyboard itself. You'll see that the color around the knobs changes depending on what color I have selected. The same thing goes for the volume meter inside of the mixer or DAW page. Any instrument or effect that you load, all of those parameters are going to appear on the keyboard. Right now, I have an analog preset loaded, and you can see that I can control all of the parameters. If I add something else like an auto filter, the keyboard instantly switches, and all of the parameters are now controlling the auto filter. This integration doesn't just work with the built-in instruments and effects in Ableton or whatever DAW you're using. Any type of plugin that I load, for example, let's say I load ROM, all of those parameters are going to be showing up on the keyboard, allowing me to control all aspects of this effect. This means that you don't have to create any custom MIDI template in order to get the same level of integration that you would if you were using something like Komplete Kontrol. Now that the play assist features are built into the keyboard, this means that any instrument that I have loaded, I can take advantage of the scales and the chords and art mode built into the keyboard. I can combine them both and have a harmonic minor scale selected, and then turn on art mode to create something cool. Let's see how this integration works using a drum rack. Just like instruments, I have access to all of the parameter controls. Because this is in a drum rack, I can access all of the parameters for the sampler and all of the effects. While most instruments and effects will auto-map, some of them you need to set up, for example, Serum. With Serum loaded, I can click on Configure, and then from here, all I need to do is select the parameters that I want to control. In this case, I'm going to select the 8 macros that are inside of Serum. Once I'm done, I'll click the Configure button again. Now, what I'll do is click here and set Save as Default so that anytime I load Serum, this mapping is automatically set. We've also improved the tempo syncing feature, which is essentially a two-way communication between the tempo in your DAW and the onboard clock inside of the keyboard. This allows for a much tighter and more accurate syncing when using something like the ARP. Switching between controlling the instruments and effects inside of your DAW and Complete Control is just as easy. I have Complete Control loaded, and just like I normally would, I can browse through all of the different brands, different products, and easily select different instruments that I want to. Clicking the instrument name at the top, this brings up the NKS2 mapping, where I can find and access all of the different parameters for this individual instrument. Clicking the encoder to the left will switch back to the Serum track. And now I can switch back to my drum rack. And now back to Complete Control. If I want to add an effect inside of Complete Control, all I have to do is hold Shift and click Add. This will bring up all of my NKS effects where I can browse and find the effect that I'm looking for. Let's load up Bite. If I want to use Kontakt instead of Complete Control, it's essentially the same thing. I can load up Kontakt, I can sort through all the different brands, and all of the Kontakt instruments I have installed on my computer. I can also load up Guitar Rig 7 directly into my instrument and effects chain. All of the parameters are pre-mapped for me, making it super easy to make this sound unique. With this level of integration, you can now really stay focused on creating music. Thanks for watching.